Let's have a quick look at this Brisbane side here. Takuri moves to fullback. Hodges and Saylor makes a pretty physically imposing back three. Devere, Walker in the centres, had a good game last week. Walker, the halves, Eichen and Berrigan. Berrigan, that is. Harrison, Delock, Carlaw, Myers in the second row. Sirinaseva, Pritis, Webke make up the front row. Plenty of interest in the halves here, with Sean Berrigan seemed to get the nod against Prince, who's unfortunately out tonight. The reserves will be Parker, Burns, Webb and Walker, Shane Walker that is. And just an interesting note here, Parker, Webb, Hodges and Harrison, you haven't seen a lot of them, they all played in the same Junior Kangaroos side.
And there's one of that quartet, Ashley Harrison. Young Lion taking the place of Kevin Campion, really. And there is Campion's team, the New Zealand Warriors. Gutsy performance at Parramatta last weekend. And Luke Pritis, among many Broncos, vying for origin selection. But, of course, he is a cockroach looking to snare the New South Wales hooking position for 2001. Of course, a lot depends on Andrew Johns and the makeup of that team. So awaiting the arrival of the home side, Kevin Campion brings out the troops. Big night for him up against his old side. And to take us through the New Zealand Warriors lineup, Tony Iroh.
The number and force changes to the New Zealand Warriors tonight. Shontayne Hapi named at fullback. We'll probably see Clinton Torpy in a number three jersey. He'll take that position. Fafili Emile on the wings. Miles at the other centre. Beverly and Jones are halves. Campion, Guttenbeel and Swan the back row. Monty Beathen in for the injured Jerry Siu Siu. Makes a front row with Jason Deeth and Ali Lautiti. And in the reserve bench, Richard Villasanti, Justin Morgan, Nat Wood, the former Rooster, gets his first start in the Warriors' colours. And young Jonathan Smith, this will be his third appearance for the Warriors. And we're looking for a great game this evening.
Now we are having a moment's silence here in memory of the father of Scott Prince, who was tragically taken in a car accident in North Queensland during the week. So standing by for a start here at Ericsson.
I'll just turn you up here to talk again, Chris, will you?
And the Warriors are running from left to right on screen. Sean Hampstead is the man in charge tonight. The Broncos defending the southern end of Ericsson Stadium. This is the 10th meeting of these teams, and the Warriors yet to break their duck against the Bronx. So we are underway, and Sirinaseva brings it back for Brisbane.
We let him up. Here we are, Warriors. Here we are, fellas. Here we are.
And he's up to the 20-metre line already.
Come on, Ali.
Webke now.
He's off. Oh,
up to the 30-metre line. And Pritis serving it up now. Gives it across to Dane Carlaw.
Dominant tackle, hands off now. Oh, Warriors, hold. Oh, Warriors.
Brisbane now still using their big men.
Come on, Warriors, come on, fellas, come on.
Almost up to halfway, Sirinaseva. And now the kick downfield from Eichen, and it'll sit up quite nicely for Torpy, and he is the acting fullback tonight in the place of Cleary. And for the first time tonight, it's a good evening to Tira Party on the sideline.
Yeah, good evening. Weather conditions down here, absolutely outstanding for rugby league. A bit of a breeze flowing from the northern end of the ground, which will favour the Warriors. Expect the intensity from the Brisbane side to come out hard and fast, as they usually do. And the Warriors, they'll look to progress to the 50-metre line. Stacey Jones tells me they'll look to lay on some smart plays with Arwen Guttenbeel.
Thank you, Tia. The Warriors in possession, 5 metres short of halfway. Beatham playing it back. Comes to Jones, and he kicks downfield. Rushing across there is Takiri, captain Fiji with distinction in the World Cup last year from fullback. And he's back there tonight in the place of Darren Lockyer. Devere from dummy half. One of the rare New South Welshmen to play for the Broncos. Now, seven receiver from dummy half. Flung to ground. 35 out from his own line. Brad Myers.
L4, Jason Deeth, hands off.
Coming into the side due to the suspension of Gordon Tallis. Now, Webke. Tough enforcer from the Darling Downs. And the go forward man for the Broncos these days. Kick downfield from Aiken. Bit of a chase on here. Torpy had some anxious moments there, but now he's rounded up the ball and the Broncos have finished him off. Shontaine Harpy. Up to the 20 metre line, right in front of the sticks, the Warriors. Slow play the ball, and the locals calling for a penalty. Lower Teedy. Deeth away from dummy half. Takes it to the line. They come the open side. Jones gives it to Gutton Beal. Harrison going low. They work the blind side. Jones with the kick. And Takiri in good field position takes it on the full. Five out from his own line. Brings it back on a wall of black and white jumpers. Being led there by Harpy. Good tackle. Good chase.
Yes, well, just a noted thing with the Brisbane side. With no Darren Lockyer at fullback, he normally stands on the left-hand side of the field and puts a big long wipers kicks in. That will fall with Ben Aiken tonight. Sean Berrigan, not a noted kicker. So let's see how much pressure they can put on Aiken.
Myers, 40 out from his own line. Berrigan sends it out the back line to Aiken on the inside. Carlo is wrapped up, five short of halfway. Seven receiver into enemy territory. Good run from the big prop. Now Aiken with the kick on the last tackle. And an awkward pick up there for Torpy. He's tackled 15 out from his own line. Henry Farfeely, his first touch of the football for tonight. Went sideways. Didn't gain too much yardage there, Henry Farfeely. Gutton Beal now straightens it up.
Let him up. Come on, Broncos. Come on behind me. Come on, Petro.
Now attacking the blind side, and they get the penalty. The Warriors get the penalty. Brisbane offside, says Hampstead. The first penalty of the match to the home side, and they will kick for touch.
And a nice safe start for both sides tonight. The Warriors will be acutely aware that last week in the first half hour they were very untidy against the Parramatta Eels, playing catch up for most of the game. Today they've made a solid start, and at the moment it's a bit of an arm wrestle, but the Warriors are doing everything right so far.
Almost 5 minutes gone, and the Warriors 30 out from the Broncos line. Cliff Beverley finds Torpy, who's come in from fullback, and now the pass on the inside to David Miles, a Queenslander by birth. Beetham. So the Warriors less than 10 out. Deeth, not sure where to go, gives it to Campion. He puts the kick in into the in goal. Takiri's back there to clean up, but a good chase. He is trapped.
Well, it looked like they went the wrong way, didn't it? Stacey Jones waiting on the right hand side of the field. Kevin Campion giving him an option on the left. Put a deft little kick in, and they get another set of six.
So the Broncos in no hurry here to restart play. Benny Aiken had a big game last week. So the restart is picked up by Jones, and he serves up the pass for Lower Teedy. And here's a handful, even for the Broncos. Jones takes it to the line. Campion running from dummy half. Now gets it away to Logan Swan. Ten metres short, the Warriors. Beverley calling for it, but Deeth goes from dummy half. Now throws a dummy, gives it on to Gutton Beal. Harpy was lurking on his outside. Deeth now working the blind side. Harpy for the line. And he's almost into touch. In fact, the flag goes up from the touchy. So Brisbane repel the Warriors. Still no score, nil all.
Nice work from the Warriors then, especially Jason Deeth taking the ball across the defensive line. and almost putting Arwin Goodenbill away. Shontayne Hubby probably taking the wrong option there. They had plenty of numbers down this side. And Myers and Hodges were good enough to take him over the sideline.
So Brisbane with loose head and feed. And Berrigan from the scrum base gives it Aiken. And Brisbane spread it straight away. Saylor promotes the football back to Aiken. Some razzle-dazzle on the first there from the Broncos. Brisbane doing all the tackling in the early stages of this round six showdown. Pritis from dummy half gives it to Saylor. Last season, seemingly with the Broncos. Brisbane attacking the blind side. Ashley Harris. A swinger to the left. Aiken takes it to the line. One-handed pass. It's been picked up there by Berrigan. He'll find himself feeding the scrums for Queensland later this year. Sean Berrigan. High ball from Aiken. Some pressure here on Farfeely. Oh, he does well. But a Bronco appears to have been taken out. Well, that's the signal from Hampstead.
You saw him, Stacey, you saw him. Can't do that, no way.
Well, my first look at this, and I think the Warriors are a little bit hard done by here. Everyone's turned around, the ball's gone up. If we get a repo, we'll have a quick look at it. Otherwise, Mr. Devere, he'll step up and go close to nailing this one. One of the most improved goal kickers over the last 3 or 4 years, Michael Devere. Not a noted goal kicker when he went to the Broncos. Here it is, we'll have a look at it. Hard to tell from there.
It's a good take by Farfeely, but all for nothing, really.
Stacey's come right across and taken the chase.
Hard to be critical, but Shontayne Hampy, I think the thing that went against him there was the fact that he was looking at the attacking players coming instead of shielding the ball and the catcher of the ball. So just a point there.
So Michael Devere will have the shot at goal, 20 out from the line, about 12 in from touch. He's averaging something like 10 points a game from memory from the first five rounds.
Conversely, the Warriors tonight, Tony, no Ivan Cleary, who has been bagging at least 10 points a game for the Warriors in the first five rounds. They'll miss him.
Certainly, Darryl, and we talked about Michael Devere being a part-time kicker a few years ago. That's what Stacey Jones still is. I imagine he'll be taking the goal kicks tonight.
Devere moves in. The touchies have waved it away. So still scoreless here at Ericsson. The Warriors and the Broncos, nil all. Michael Devere got 7 from 9 last week against Newcastle, so he'd be disappointed with that. The restart from the 20-metre line, with the dropout. And it's a booming kick. And looks like it's hit Berrigan on the head. Well, in Australian Rugby League terminology, we call that a falcon. Not sure if I've got the licence to use that here at Ericsson, but that's what it was. Berrigan getting to his feet, and Saylor now with the hit up. Up to the 30-metre line. Pritis from dummy half gives it to Sivanasiva. It was a flat pass, but it was okay. Five short of halfway. Webke. They drive him. Pritis picking his moments. Went to run from dummy half.
L5 and last. 0M, worry, 0M.
Aiken was hounded by Stacey Jones. He got a kick away, though, and the bounce could be favourable for the Broncos. It is. They picked it up. Out wide it comes to Hodges. And the flyer from Cairns looking to score the first try. He's gone so close. He's taken the flag. The touch, he hasn't raised his flag. But the corner stick has been flattened, and Hampstead will go upstairs.
Well, the first thing I'd be looking at would be whether these runners are offside, because Aiken was taken back. He hesitated on his kick. That means his attacking line was way in front of him. And it'll be interesting to see whether the man who received the ball off the kick was actually behind him.
Well, the replay should reveal something here, because Hodges seemed pretty confident. So did the linesman. It was a terrible bounce for the locals. And here's Hodges going for the corner. Got away from Torpy. And, well...
well, he's done well, hasn't he? Justin Hodges there, as we see the kick. Now, if it's touched someone there, Stacey, I think it is, everyone's onside. If not, the person getting the ball will in fact be in front of the kicker by at least 10 yards.
Well, this will be an interesting call here for Chris Ward, the video ref. And frame by frame, it seems to be a try.
Try.
So the first thing was offside to consider, and the second was the grounding, whether he took the corner flag.
Yep. Yep. Yep.
Decision pending here. And still waiting at Ericsson. Stand by. Well, still no score here at Ericsson Stadium. Hodges is denied by Chris Ward upstairs.
Well, that amazes me. They've given it no try in the corner, obviously, because it's gone into touch. I thought the man was offside.
Definitely, Stacey Jones didn't touch that ball. So
come on, hands off now. Come on.
A bit of luck there for the Warriors, because from our view, it certainly looked like Hodges had got the ball down. But a justified decision in the end.
So Campion now working from dummy half. 12 minutes gone. And still no score. The Warriors up to halfway. Beverly gives it on to Jones. Goodenbeel. There was a half gap. It closed quickly. Myers tackles him. Last tackle now for the Warriors. Jones going to the air. Looking for Harpy. They've lost it. The Broncos. Barfield picks up the scratch. Henry Barfield. He's over. First try of the match to the Warriors. Oh, great kick and some pressure on the Broncos, and Henry Farfeely needed no invitation.
Stacey Jones with a little banana kick that time, and in fact he fooled one of his own players, Shontaine Harpy, who didn't even realise the ball was coming his way. We look here, Stacey puts it back to the right hand side. Harpy's not really interested. Hang on, here it comes. I'll take this man out. Farfeely's got enough. A nice step inside to Kerry and over. He's a try-scoring machine for Feely.
Well, it was a kick off the side of the boot, wasn't it? Planned, though, from Stacey Jones. The knock-on there. Does well with the pick-up. Good footwork. Gets down. Over it goes. The thing I like about that with the Warriors, it was a very, very good set of six. They looked to move the ball to this right-hand side of the field, and they had some depth. Arwen Gutenbill came through. This is the end result, obviously. Good pick-up, not easy to do. Good step. And they moved the ball to the right-hand side of the field. They looked as though they were going to spread it left. A set play. Kick to the wrong side of the field, to the blind side, and a try.
Second try for 2001, Henry Farfeely. And with no Ivan Cleary tonight, Stacey Jones will have the shot at goal. But Justin Hodges there, obviously unlucky not to get the try for Brisbane at the other end of the field, and then put under a lot of pressure with the kick, and it was he that came up with the spill. And interesting to know during the week too, Darryl, that the goal-kicking tees, that obviously you have a lot of time for, have been basically outlawed. They're only permitted now for shots at goal. But I see Jones using the sand here.
Yeah, Stacey. She'll be using a tee, Stacey. But no, yes. The tees have been outlawed for the kicking off purposes, Jason. Nothing to do with goal-kicking at all. I think they feel the NRL, that the height you can manufacture the tee to get the ball up in the air from the kickoff is giving some sides an unfair advantage.
Jones's kick coming around, but it shaves the left upright. No goal. So the score remains 4-0, the Warriors over the Broncos. The restart coming up here for Michael Davila. Almost 15 minutes gone and Campion brings it back. Lower Titi. Guttenbeel now taking it to the line. So the Warriors have weathered the storm. 4-0 they lead after that near thing involving Justin Hodges and Tira Party, I suppose. That's an ideal start for the Warriors. They hung in there.
Absolutely ideal start for the Warriors. One of the key elements in this match was that they needed to contain this Broncos side in the early stages. Stacey Jones, who put that kick up for Henry Farfelli to score, can often be seen as he has a little nab, often be seen at training here 20 minutes after everybody's gone practicing those sorts of kicks, and Henry Farfelli has scored 23 tries in one season for the Manurewa Marlins.
Tia, just a quick point, no Gordon Tallis there for the Broncos. Who's doing the talking behind that Brisbane side?
Well, obviously the whole Brisbane side, they've got plenty of chat out there, they're not short on any talk whatsoever, but Kevin Campion very unlucky not to pick up that ball. But it's a Broncos side who've got plenty of chat, but it's a Warriors side that are on fire at the moment, and Kevin Campion has certainly never let up on his troops yet.
Campion unable to pull off the intercept there from the pass from Benny Eichen. Justin Morgan scored a try against his old side last week. He's warming up on the sideline. Davila now. Warriors in possession, 8 minutes as opposed to Brisbane, 6. Brisbane almost up to halfway. Sivanasiva. Some good yardage there for the Broncos. Centre field, 40 metres out. Prittis from dummy half, gives it to Berrigan, on to Eichen. He's running the football to the line. Taken by Logan Swan. They come back the open side. Berrigan. He's looking for a runner, but he takes the tackle of Lower Titi. Eichen. Cut out pass to Myers running wide on the last tackle. Brisbane spreading it, but the Warriors are up to it. Good defence from the home side and a quick play of the ball too. And here's the try scorer, Henry Farfelli.
L2, come on, Broncos, come on.
The Warriors
on, come
up
on.
To the 30-metre line now. Monty Beetham plays it back. Torpy up from fullback. Gives it to Lower Titi.
L3,
he was very much involved in that big comeback against Parramatta last week. Beverly with the kick downfield. And it's rolling end on end into the end goal. And it will go dead end goal.
It's a nice option though there from Beverly, just turning the Brisbane team around, and a great chase as well. Imperative that they get a great chase on this Broncos side when you consider the arsenal they've got at the back. The loss of Lockyer is pretty much countered by Hodges, and when you put Takiri and Saylor in the mix, they're pretty potent.
Well, Saylor milks the penalty there, and he gives the Warriors a big stare. He's still going on with it, Wendell. But the penalty to Brisbane here, all over the tackle player.
Never short for a word on the field, is he, Big Windy, eh? If looks, good kill.
2-1 the penalties in favour of the Broncos. They find touch on the far side of the ground. Sivanasiva. It's tackle number one. They're 40 out, Brisbane. They swing it to Berrigan. Links up with Webkey. And how's that for stats? 100% ball control for both sides. Prittis from dummy half. Put away by Justin Morgan. Right in front of the sticks, the Bronx. 15 out. They come the left side. Eichen holds the pass up for Takiri. They snuffed out there by Harpy. Good tackle from Shontaine Harpy. Eichen Berrigan taking it to the line again. Sean Berrigan still going. Little man with a big heart. Last tackle coming up for the Broncos. Little kick in behind the line. Campion can't collect it, but it's been scooped up by Torpy. And the pressure off the Warriors again. Seems to be some concern in back play too for Shane Webke, limping around, they tell me. See the replay here, the little kick not coming off of the Broncos, and right on the spot there was Clinton Torpy.
That's the second time in the last three or four sets for the Brisbane side that they've had a crack at the line. The first time they got caught with the ball on the fifth tackle, as the Warriors move wide.
David Miles rounded up by Chris Walker. Beverly shifts it to Jones. Some boost for offside from the Warriors faithful. Hodges this time on the full, no problem. And he brings it back. He's upended. Campion leading the way.
Hands off, come on.
Both sides doing a bit of tackling, but nothing really in it. So to the missed tackles, three apiece in that department.
Come on. Oh, fellas, hold this plate, Wendell.
Brisbane now crossing halfway with Walker. It's Chris. Stood up Robbie O'Davis last week. He is a fine prospect, Chris Walker.
Knock on.
Jolting tackle there, spills the ball. Heavy stuff, and the Warriors come up with the pill. And almost a penalty. In fact, Sean Hempstead has read my mind, and he's heard the call from the fans.
Great tackle there by Cliff Beverley, jolting the ball free. And the Warriors doing everything right here at the moment, considering they're playing basically a prop short with Deeth and Beetham up the front row. The go forward's pretty good, and they've got plenty of variety.
Wayne Bennett giving Corey Parker, the bald-headed man out there, his first taste of big-time footy, a former junior kangaroo.
Now Justin Morgan was involved in that tackle which forced the spill. Beetham gives it to Campion. Swan powering towards the line and he's over. Second try of the game to the Warriors. Logan Swan hitting the ball at pace. And he is awarded the try. And the Warriors making a fine start. They lead the Broncos 8-0.
And the first handling error in the game from the Brisbane Broncos meant the New Zealand Warriors were in a great attacking position. And Logan Swan doing what he does best. Here's a tackle by Beverley. Jolts it free. From that turnover and subsequent penalty, they went to the left. And Swan hitting the gap at pace. Too strong. Shrugs off a couple of tackles.
Well, you've got to like that, don't you? Logan Swan, for the last few weeks, you've been doing it every game. Running a straight line, busts a couple of tackles. Not the best of a 10 from Eichen there. Well done, Logan Swan. They've done well. Arwen Goondenbill had a huge run in the first try, or the tackle preceding the first try. And now, on the left-hand side of the field, it's the other second rower. He gets it himself, Logan Swan.
His second try for 2001.
Stacey's gone to a tee.
Doing the right thing by the manufacturers. Darryl. Jones moves in. And he's nailed.
Result.
Oh, it speaks for itself, doesn't it? 10-0, the Warriors over the Broncos.
You go back to Cliff Beverley with their great tackle. That's what laid them in this position. And Logan Swan, they've got a new piece of gym equipment in the gymnasium. It's a twister. He's been using that all week, and that, he's certainly used it to the fore when scoring that try.
Yeah, good, Tia.
Nothing like a good twister. Now the Warriors bring it back with Justin Morgan. 24 minutes gone. The Warriors leading 10-0, two tries to nil.
Come on.
And in spite of the absence of Lockyer and Tellis and Scotty Prince, Brisbane expected to win this match tonight. Beetham from dummy half gives it to Campion. He holds the pass up and It come off the back of Swan, the try scorer. So it is play on. Morgan again. Last tackle coming up for the Warriors. Beverly does well, gives it to Jones, gets a kick away. And it sits up perfectly there for Lottie Takiri. Fijian flyer trying to penetrate the line. Some good tackling going on out there from Richie Villasanti in 15. Here's Parker.
Help two, hands off now. Warriors hold now. Hold, Warriors hold.
10 metres short of halfway. Brisbane working the blind side. Stalled run there from Saylor. From a standing start though. Look at him go. Still the best winger in the world for mine. Perhaps in either code. We'll soon find out. Interchanges 2-1 in favour of the Warriors. Myers is away and he's got support. Parker for the line. Big night for him and he gets over the whitewash right under the black dot. Brisbane strike back. Parker gets the try, the new kid on the block, and it's 10-4.
Well, he's been on the field for a minute, but disappointment for the Warriors. They've done everything right for 25 minutes, but this is how dangerous this Broncos side is. And the Broncos get a try that they really needed.
Well, not to point fingers, but this did look a little bit easy, didn't it? Just flat-footed there. Good ball by Myers too. And look at it, a new haircut. A new start. How about that for your first one?
Yeah, it was a great ball here from Aiken. He took it to the line. They just didn't read the numbers right. And Myers was good enough to see Parker backing up under the post.
The Broncos have hit back, haven't they? In that set of six, Wendell Saylor got himself involved twice. On the second play of the ball, a great scoot out of dummy half, put him in striking distance.
Well, Davia should be able to throw this one over. The mother of sitters.
I think if you ask Corey Parker, he'd probably like this one.
Davia, right in front. Flags are raised, and we have a four-point ball game. Warriors leading 10-6.
Broncos really did run some fantastic lines here. Everyone was straight, everyone was on the job, and Corey Parker, he's been warming up for some 15 minutes before he got on. He'll be absolutely wrapped with that effort.
Tiara, see just big Webke walking past you there. He's getting a breather, or is there something wrong with him?
Just a breather at this stage, I believe. He's sucking pretty hard, and it has been pretty tough out there for the boys.
And Tia, they have another monster ready to come on in Carl Webb. He's a big man.
He's a big unit standing next to Webke. He doesn't look too much different either. So, obviously, Coach Wayne Bennett looking to use a bit of size and get a few more energy levels up out there for the Broncos.
Hodges now from dummy half, and he goes right through the first line. He's chopped down by Torpy. Oh, there was a must tackle, that one. Sivanasiva. Oh, copybook tackle there. Villasanti. The Broncos now seem to have their tails up with 12 minutes to go until half-time. 2-1 the line breaks in favour of the home side as Aiken fires a big cutout pass. Walker put away. 10 in from touch. They come the open side, Brisbane. Aiken now sets himself with a kick, and it's a pretty good one too. Some pressure back here on Farfeely. It's been battered back by the Broncos and dived on by the Warriors. Campion obliges. Sloppy play of the ball, but it's okay. And in fact, it's a penalty against the Broncos. Prittis, the offender. Jones kicking for touch. A pretty good kick too, 5 metres into enemy territory. We see the replay here of Goodenbeel being tackled. Morgan.
And Nat Woodon for his first start for the Warriors.
And there he is in 18 in the headgear, the former Rooster. Villasanti. His first run for the Warriors. Nat Wood. Justin Morgan now. 22 out right in front of the sticks. The Warriors by four. Nat Wood from dummy half. Puts the fend on. Only a little man, Nat Wood. Jones gives it across to Guttenbeel. Plenty of defence there, and the ball's come free. And it's been knocked on, says Hampstead. No strip involved. But the crowd that's turned out, they think otherwise.
Well, I think you got it right, Hampstead. Once again, the Warriors using their big second rows down the corridors. We'll just watch this there. He just seemed to get a little bit of a knock and carried the ball high around his head, and in the end, hard to tell.
Oh, here you go. Yeah, Luke's got it over there. I don't know why he's
that was the Warriors' first handling error. So 30 minutes into the game, they've done quite well, the home side. Sailor got it away. Walker, he's got some toe, this bloke. Comes from a talented family in Toowoomba. His brother Shane on the bench listed tonight in 16. And the other part of the jigsaw, of course, Ben Walker, now playing for the Northern Eagles. Played last night, scoring a double in a losing side against the Dragons. Less than 10 to go before half time. Webb is the monster that I was talking about. Got it away. Unbelievable. Wasn't the prettiest of passes, but that's Brisbane style. Get it out the back door if you can. Prittis. Almost went for it. Attack the blind side. Harrison with a kick. Torpy's over there and lets it go into touch.
Saw an interesting article on young Chris Walker during the week. He says he drifts in and out of games, and if a scrum happens or something, he looks for his mum and dad in the crowd. And you might see him talking a lot because Wayne Bennett's got him sort of talking to himself to keep himself focused. So hope his mum and dad aren't here and he doesn't get carried away.
Well, they'd have to be up the top of Mount Lofty overlooking the garden city of Toowoomba for that to happen. Somehow I don't think that would be the case.
Go in, Luke.
The scrum to form, 10 out from the Warriors' line.
Wait a minute, Matty. Let it out.
Jones gives it to Torpy.
Got one, hands off now, hands off.
Little Sandy. Jones on to Morgan. And he got it away to Campion. Terrific ball, Campion on the spin, on the merry-go-round, on the hurdy-gurdy, call it what you wish, but it was a fine piece of support play from Kevin Campion and compounded for the Broncos with the penalty. So the Warriors on a bit of a roll here with less than eight to go before half-time. So a quick touch finder, 4-2 the penalties in favour of the Warriors. Swan scored the last try for the Warriors. Nat Wood from dummy half. Steals about five before he's tackled. Jones inside ball to Villasanti. The pass looked a bit sus. Hampstead says play on. Pass from Beverly to nobody. Stop start affair here for Logan Swan. Finds Jones. Gives it to Torpy now. Crossfield. Now he straightens it up. Berrigan involved for Brisbane. 10 metres out, they come the open side to Jones. Morgan back for Stacey Jones. Cut out pass, some pressure. Sailor come out of the line. Campion, there's an overlap. Miles on the far side of the field. Francis Melly, no room to move, but it was exciting stuff on the far side of the field.
Well, great ball movement, wasn't it? Right across the field. The Warriors seem to be standing still on about the 20-metre zone, just shuffling the ball around. Torpy put a dent in them. Wendell come off his wing. Good ball. Wanted to get down low here. It was always going to be a tough one. He's very, very close to that sideline, right in that touchline. Good ball movement.
Melly there running out of real estate. So Brisbane breathing a sigh of relief. They're still trailed by four, though. And now they're rucking it out. Chance to go sideline again, Tia. What's happening down there?
The Warriors, obviously, with Francis Melly running out there obviously disappointed with that. Not too much movement on the bench. Everybody pretty content to sit and ride through these last few minutes of this first half.
Hell, hands off now, hands off.
So Webb tackle, five short of halfway. Berrigan, pass. Well, it was right in front of us. Didn't go backwards for mine. Eichen now gives it across to Hodges. The kick over the top is into the end goal. Torpy's back there, has to force it. So it's worked out well here for Brisbane. They'll get another shot at the Warriors.
Well, Hodges have not much to do there and put a deft little kick in. And a great restart for the Broncos. They probably weren't expecting that. Eichen running the ball on the last tackle.
Trying to do well here, trying to shade the ball out. Michael Devere putting the pressure on, makes the play, makes him play it dead. Result, the Broncos, they'll get the ball back.
Right, fellas, Stavey on the kicker. Oh, he kicks it.
5 minutes away from the interval.
Stavey on the kicker.
And the restart from Torpy.
Ali Lautiti's moved on to the field in place of Justin Morgan.
Thank you, Tia. Seven receiver now, bringing it back for the Broncos. So a testing time coming up here for the locals. Brisbane looking to square the ledger. Oh, terrific stuff there. Phyllis Sandman. Berrigan. Got it away. Play on if they can dive on it. It is play on. Eichen now keeps it alive. Back for Seven receiver. Taken by Lauatiti. 15 out, Brisbane. Eichen holding up the pass, and he's ruled it went forward. Well, from up here, it seemed okay. There's been some similar passes, and Hampstead pulling this one up, Darrell.
Yes, he has. It looked okay from here, didn't it? Look, that's gone backwards. Shontaine Harpy could have just about caught it himself. It's been a few flat ones. Could have let it go.
Right on, Broncos, Warriors, you got the feed. Oh, Luke, go down, mate. Man, you're back, Luke.
Harpy doing well for the Warriors, back from a sternum injury tonight.
Broncos, just go down and stand there, fellas. Go down and stand there, Broncos.
So they put in with Jones, and the Warriors spread it to Francis Mellon.
Top one, hands up now. Here we are, Broncos, here we are.
Attacking the blind. And something's gone on in the tackle here. Ashley Harrison possibly in some trouble. He was sailing close to the win last week. Keep him down is the call from Hampstead. He wasn't placed on report, but the penalty goes to the Warriors.
Just a bit sloppy, wasn't it? Richard Villasanti, Tony, had a little bit of an impact in this game.
Well, he's most damaging runner tonight. He's put on some great hits, and the Broncos players just having a little look over their shoulder now.
Jones, Guttenbeel. Brisbane leading the interchange count 4-3 as Lauatiti takes it to the line. And the Warriors doing a little bit more defensive work thus far. 2.5 to go until half time as the NZ Warriors take it to the line. And I'll tell you what, he's been poleaxed there, Cliff Beverley. Campion, little kick in behind the line. Sailor's back there, into the end goal. He's trapped, he's big, but he can't get away. And don't the fans love that? Wendell Sailor, the talk of rugby league and rugby union some time ago. And
well,
he's a superstar.
Value for money, isn't he, Wendell Sailor? Kevin Campion showing his kicking game again. It's a great kick. Wendell, never say die. Wendell, away from one, just short.
And twice now Campion putting the ball and getting a restart for the Auckland New Zealand Warriors. He knows more than anyone that they have to dominate possession in this game and dominate territorially as well.
The restart from Eichen. It's cut off there by Guttenbeel. Now he straightens it up and still going. Arwen Guttenbeel, so some flimsy defence there. That was a sloppy play of the ball. But the Warriors will get the penalty. Prittis is blowing up. He can't believe it, the hooker.
Well, he should be blown up at his teammate Carl Webb then, because Carl Webb's hand was all over that ball. And this should allow Stacey, hopefully put the Warriors out by 6 points.
Well, there was a hand in there for sure. Prittis, tell you what, you must think Sean Hampstead is off to the optometrist on a regular basis, because that was silly stuff from the number nine.
It certainly was. The tackle had already been made, and Prittis just coming down to slow to play the ball down, decides he stick his arm in there. They've been trying to get rid of that for a year or two now, and that's the way you do it.
Good luck to him too, Darryl. It's all a matter of consistency, of course. Jones, the added responsibility of kicking the goals tonight, moves in, strikes it okay. The crowd like it, so too the touchies. The Warriors lead out to 6 points now, with halftime fast approaching. They lead Brisbane 12-6. And we are back underway. Short restart with the motorbike off the playing arena. And it didn't come off for Brisbane. Shallow restart. The Warriors come up with it. And halftime hooter sounds in the background. And that is the end of the first 40. Oh no, the Broncos have come up with a ball from a steal of some description. They spread it now. Chris Walk, inside ball for Wendell Saylor. It's not over yet. Brisbane now with Parker. He can't promote the ball. And now that is halftime, surely. Well, I can't believe my eyes.
Well, we're all off to get a hot dog, weren't we? Out the back of the grandstand, but no, it was still alive, Tony.
And that's why you don't want to be a first grade coach. And of all people, Kevin Campion.
Well, just poor ball security. It was a one-on-one strip, and then Prittis set the scene for the Broncos. Unbelievable finish to the first half, but it's the Warriors in the box seat after the opening 40. They lead the Brisbane Broncos here at Ericsson 12-6. Back underway here at Ericsson. And the Warriors now bring it back with Ali Loatiti. Matt Wood back on the field in the second half. Looking at a dummy half and a bust now by Richard Villasanti. He stood tall tonight for the Warriors. Huge run and takes the Warriors downtown big time. 40 out. Home side on a roll in the opening minute of the second half. Stacey Jones now throws the dummy. And out the back door, got it away to Campion. Good second phase play here from the Warriors. Logan Swan put away. 25 out.
Villasanti down and back play.
Beverly attacking the blind, gives it to David Miles. Nat Wood from dummy half. Again, they work the blind side. Campion gives it away to Torpy out the back door. Malley bats it back to Miles. Not sure which way to go. Eventually, he takes it to the line. 15 metres out, David Miles. Plays it back for Nat Wood. Beverly goes to the air, looking for Farfeely. It's been batted back. The Warriors still in possession. Harpy got it away. Still on here for Farfeely in the corner, into the end goal. But Brisbane are trapped. They came up with the ball, but they couldn't get out of the end goal. Takiri, he was jammed.
Great work by the Warriors then. A clever little kick by Beverly. Probably not deep enough, but Farfeely was good enough to get up. And Harpy just getting the ball free. The tackle we count hadn't started. Guttenbeel getting a nice set of six start again for the Warriors.
Well, they reckon rugby union and league are getting close together. Just about a maul there, getting the ball back there.
3-3, the dropouts. And this one will be picked up by Torpy in the number three jumper, but playing fullback tonight. If you've joined us late, no Ivan Cleary for the Warriors this evening. He was ruled out late in the day due to food poisoning. Nat Wood turns it on the inside, gives it to Villasanti. He took a knock, but he's back. Wood gives it on to Beverly. Inside ball to Loatiti. Marching towards the line, back to Torpy. Torpy now back for Wood. Nat Wood claps on the pace. And he's only 2 metres short. Beverly from dummy half. Campion. And again. Kevin Campion put away.
The last on the line, Broncos.
Last tackle. 5 metres out, the Warriors.
Dinner.
Wood for Beverly. Kicking behind the line. Oh, it's been dived on. And Brisbane hold out. But the Warriors will get another set. Walker did well. So some sustained play there from the Warriors. Tia.
Yeah, important that the Warriors, whenever they are down this end of the field, they do apply a lot of pressure. And it's very, very interesting to note that tonight they have done that on every occasion. Coach Wayne Bennett emphasised to his troops at half-time that they really are in a match and they really do need to keep the intensity levels very high if they're going to come out with a win.
Lowatiti now, and he's gone right through the Brisbane defence. Lowatiti for the line. 10 metres out back to Nat Wood. Good support play from the Mr. Fix-It in 18. 5 metres out, the Warriors now growing an extra arm and a leg. Miles out the back door. Francis Malley, he's barged over the sideline. Ah, oh, big let off there for Brisbane, but some holes appearing in the Broncos line, Tony.
Well, some enterprising play by the Warriors. This time it was David Miles with a little flick pass out the back. But look at Lowatiti, one of the most feared runners in the NRL, and showing why, and he's got a step on him as well, this boy. 110 kilos, he can move. Nat Wood doing what he did well at the Roosters. Great support play. And look at this little flick pass by Miles. Melee just failing to take that.
Berrigan now from the scrum base. Up to the 20-metre line.
One hands off, your hands off.
Webkey.
L2, let him up now. Come on, Warriors, come on.
Tritis from dummy half. Sailor coming in off the flank. And he's not put on his backside.
Hands up, hands up, hands
with a physique up like his, it's pretty hard to put away. Seven Asiva. Kept it alive, back for Tritis. Links up with Parker. Scored a try in the first half. Aiken. Inside ball to Webke. Webke goes through. Torpy's there. Last tackle now for the Broncos. 12 metres out, Brisbane. They swing it to the left. Berrigan. Berrigan on the last running it. Berrigan still going. And he's tackled. Oh, some anxious moments there. But Torpy, again, doing the job for the Warriors.
Yes, Webke goes straight through, doesn't he? He's a big man. Well done, Clinton Torpy. Gets him from dummy half now and taking a run out. It's the second or third time tonight Brisbane have died with the ball on their last tackle play. A play where the ball normally ends up in Darren Lockyer's hands. Certainly missing Darren Lockyer tonight.
So the Warriors now on tackle number three. Swan plays it back to Nat Wood. And Lowatiti. He's been outstanding again tonight for the Warriors. Rodney Beetham. And fine run there from Beetham. Last tackle now for the Warriors. Jones, little grubber in. Coming through is Cliff Beverley. And he had the bounce, but he let it bounce again. And it was a very slow pickup in the end by Beverley. And you can hear the call from Hampstead there. One-on-one steal, Brisbane in possession.
Looks like a problem here for Benny Aiken, a dead shoulder. He's just a passenger in there at the moment. Keep an eye on him, Tia.
L2. Come on, fellas, come on, fellas. Come on.
See the kick in behind the line there. And well, Beverly sort of had the chance to get the ball back. But anyway, one-on-one steal has Brisbane back in possession on the halfway line. Sailor tries to play it on Beverly, of all people. And Brisbane now in possession, 40 out from the Warriors' line. Seven Asiva. Straight and hard, got it away to Pritis. Now to Webke. Webke goes through a hole. And Berrigan's lost it. And Torpy comes away with the scraps, puts the step on, gets past it. Still going, Clinton Torpy, and Ericsson Stadium is alive. He's got support. Francis Malley, the pass over the top. Malley's away, but Hampstead, he's going to bring it back. Malley's away. Oh, look, they're still playing on the Warriors. They don't realise. Well, just as well, too, Henry Farfeely. He had a rush of blood with 5 metres to travel, but Sean Hampstead.
They're still going.
The Warriors bench very animated there, and it's taken a while for some of them to wake up. Henry Farfeely was one of them. He plays to the whistle, Darryl.
Yeah, very well done, wasn't it? A great run by Torpy up the middle. Big step,
you didn't know he had one, look at that. He's got it right there, and he takes off. Good chase by the Broncos. And yes, no, that's a good call. Hempstead right in line with it. Could only call one way.
And Jason Deeth there and Mark Turkey realising belatedly that there would be no try. Berrigan now gives it out to Takiri. Now the Broncos breaking tackles. Webke, Shane Webke again. Torpy pulls off a big tackle and he forces the knock on. Oh, Torpy, he's on fire.
Well, that's the third time Shane Webke's made big runs. He split open the Auckland defence and they've really got to tighten up out on those flanks, the Warriors. Torpy's done well on two occasions now to bring him down. But here's the prop running like a three-quarter.
This is just what Wayne Bennett would have been asking for at half-time from his senior players. Webke, Saylor, get involved, make the difference. He's done that. Unfortunately, small mistake at the end. Pressure's off.
Harvey also involved in that tackle, which forced the mistake. And speak of the devil, here he is. From dummy half, Jones going for a gallop.
Help to the mark, come Broncos, come on. Petro, that was it, mate. Come on, Petro.
Beverly, Swan, crosses halfway, Logan Swan. Brisbane looking flimsy in defence. Not the sort of defence that's won them five premierships since they joined the competition way back in 88. Quick hands from the Warriors to Melly. And that's got to be a penalty. For Wendell Saylor, he had every intention of putting him on the running track here at Ericsson.
He certainly does, and Wendell pulling him over the sideline there. Keep an eye on Ben Eichen. I'm sure he's running with a right shoulder injury. Logan Swan taking advantage of that and running at it, making good yards.
Well, Tia, that happened right in front of you. I can't believe it. Saylor, the captain tonight, he should have known better.
Yeah, he really should have. Just silly play from Wendell, and he'll be pretty disappointed with that. Ben Eichen, you're absolutely right, Daryl. He is struggling with a left shoulder, and it was on that occasion Logan Swan who went searching for them, expecting the Vodafone Warriors to go looking for him more often.
Beetham now. Ronnie Beetham. 5 metres out, right in front of the sticks. That's tackle number one. 10 minutes gone in the second half. Nat Wood showing it. Crossfield, got it away. Lowatiti now. Lowatiti. Now, set move from dummy half. There was two players in the dummy half position. Brisbane didn't get sucked in, though. And just as well, they hold the line, but only just.
Old mousetrap.
Jones, you're kicking behind the line. Oh, Berrigan, he's done well. Slippers catch that one, and he keeps the ball alive. Dusting pass out wide to Chris Walker. Luckily for Brisbane, it went backwards.
Come on, Warriors, come on, behind me. Come on, Ali, 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 that's it, mate.
Heavy tackling going on out there from Swan. Davia centralising play for the Broncos. And Brisbane now 5 metres short of halfway. Fine run there from Dane Carlaw. Saylor getting involved. Brisbane keeping the ball alive. Comes out on the far side of the field. And another turnover. And the Warriors come away with it.
Well, you don't like to see that, do you? Benny Eichen, he's just as though he's been shot with a shotgun in his leg.
Shane Walker wasn't happy. And you can see Eichen, he's in all sorts of strife. We watched the replay. Eichen playing wounded. And you can see there, it's all gone wrong. The footwork not happening according to plan.
Yeah, the left knee looks like it's just collapsed underneath him.
And that could be a body blow, not only for the Broncos, but state of origin, not too far away in Queensland. Not.
Don't worry about playing wounded, Costo. Poor old Benny Eichen's flat out and he hasn't moved.
Queensland not endowed with a lot of halves, high caliber halves at this stage. Certainly not compared to New South Wales, and Eichen looks gone.
Just seemed to
Beer's knee just collapsed underneath him. He gets some assistance. Oh, yeah. Went to step off that left knee. You could see it on his face straight away. No problem for Arwen Gutenbill. He'll take the ball. Thank you very much. That's a sorry sight, that. Ben Eichen just stepping up into the Brisbane 5-8 role. Took a lot of pressure off a side without Darren Lockyer last week. He is their kicker. A lot revolves around him. It's a very, very sad sight.
Huge blow for the Broncos.
Yeah.
So Wendell Saylor now with the job in front of him.
Right on your fourth,
acting
step,
captain tonight as Eichen goes to the bench. That knee is going to get some treatment very, very shortly, no doubt.
And another former Rooster, Darren Burns, takes his spot.
Here I am, Broncos. Here I come, Broncos.
And Darren Burns, they call him Compass. He's played north, south, east, west. The up and under. And a knock on. Well, the Broncos are collapsing here. Things are falling apart. Berrigan there. He can't agree with the decision. So the Warriors will have the put in here. The scrum will form. 20 out. Watch the replay. Batted back. And there's the knock on. Tough call, some would say.
Well, the masters, aren't they, Brisbane? But they're very, very good at absorbing pressure. And they've had a lot on them in the last 10 minutes. The scoreboard still, however, 12-6.
Jones to Beverly. Miles taken by Saylor. Jones, inside ball, beat them. Myers can't put him away. Deef keeps it alive. Jones, Torpy up from fullback. He needed to spread it.
That ball had to go. There were three lining up for it. A try in the right-hand corner.
Now they come back to the left side. Jones, Lowatiti, powering towards the line. He'll take some stopping again. Just short, Ali Lowatiti. Deef throws the dummy. Now comes back the right side. Torpy in possession of the ball. Puts the step on Clinton Torpy. Got it away too.
Gutenbill.
And Gutenbill is just short of the line. The Warriors pressing here for
big numbers to the left.
A try. Jones, the kick in behind the line, and it's been forced dead. Good clean-up work there at the back. Shane Walker in the headgear.
Well, the next best result, but the Warriors on two occasions went the wrong way. Stacey Jones tidies up with a neat little kick. But firstly, on the right-hand side, Torby couldn't get a pass away when he had three men outside him. And on the left-hand side, Beverly just caught. And Miles unable to get another pass away when they had numbers begging.
So the restart now from the goal line. The Warriors getting a real run of things at this stage. 24 minutes to go. Brisbane can put on quick points. The Warriors now in possession, 30 metres out. Campion getting to his feet. Jones. Gutenbill. Held by Myers and Berrigan. Now the left side to Jones. Beverly. If Beverly takes it himself. And get to his feet. Plays it back. Jones working the blind side. Quick hands. Myles. Melly. Melly for the line. Got it back to David Miles, and he's over the touchline. Well, Miles is blowing up. He's given the touchy his thoughts on the matter. Got some quick hands there from the Warriors.
Well,
on the short
they
side.
Stack this side, don't they? Two or three players in the space of about 5 metres. Stacey Jones gets a good ball away. This one here gets down low, and just when you think the ball's dead, out the back door, Miles, foot and touch. Desperation from the Broncos once again.
Brisbane having to do a little bit more tackling tonight. Brisbane, with the all-important put-in, they have survived raid after raid in the last 10 minutes or so. Bennett would be pleased with that. They're only averaging 16 points in defence, the Broncos. Brisbane still trying to get upfield. They haven't been up the other end for some time. And they're almost up to halfway. Slow play the ball. Now it comes to Berrigan. And he drills it downfield. And this turns Torpy right around. And a deft kick it is, because Torpy has a job to get out of the in goal. Oh, he's done well. He's back in the field of play, but only just.
Well, in the absence of Benny Eichen, Sean Berrigan takes the chance to kick the ball and comes up with a great result.
Well, it was near perfect. Torpy doing a fine job tonight in the absence of Ivan Cleary. Malley now in off the wing. Some of the Warriors battling fatigue, slow to get back on side as Deeth gives it away. And Beetham plays it back. Beverly trying to slice through. That's a knock-on. Knock-on from Owen Guttenbeel. And that could be the break that the Broncos need, Darryl.
Well, this New Zealand side had five or six sets on the, as we look at the ball. Hard to take. One that really needed to be. Is it the one that lets the Broncos out of jail? They've been defending their own line what seems to be an eternity. They finally get the ball back inside the New Zealand 40.
7-4, the handling errors against the Bronx. And not far off the 1 hour mark, Tia, obviously entering a very critical stage this match.
A very critical stage indeed, and both coaches playing a tactical game with some six changes made by Daniel Anderson, and the Broncos up to around nine changes now with another change coming up.
Brisbane looking to square the ledger. Walker inside ball for Shane Webke. That was Shane Walker providing the pass. Now they come the left side, Berrigan. Berrigan running the ball. Berrigan's reached out. He's over. Brisbane get their second try. Sean Berrigan is awarded the try. And that could be a turning point. Brisbane get it back to 12-10. Kick to come.
Well, even though the Warriors have dominated possession for the last 10 minutes, they look a little fatigued now. Berrigan taking advantage of that. The line stood still. And he was good enough. He's very strong, Berrigan.
Oh, he's good, isn't he? He's very, very quick on his feet. He's harder to tackle than what he looks. Has good balance, and just that extra step and that reach out means he gets one down.
The defensive line just stopped moving for a second. That was all he needed.
Just burrowing under at the end there.
His second try for 2001, Sean Berrigan, one of the many youngsters who've come into this Brisbane side over the years. Many of them spotted by the great talent scout, the former Rockhampton school teacher and former rugby league international for the Kangaroos, Cyril Connell. Very much responsible for a lot of the players you see here tonight and beforehand. So this is Michael Devere here lining up the kick. And he should level the scores here. Some heckling for Michael Devere. But he's not put off by that. 12-12, locked up ball game here at Ericsson. The Broncos, are they on the way back? We'll soon find out. Yep. Okay, yep.
Stadium to kick it while he kicks it. Hopefully he kicks it.
So the restart now coming up for the New Zealand Warriors. Torpy does the honours. And it's brought back on the fly by Buddy Dekiri.
Here, Warriors, here we go. Ali.
Sivana Siva.
L2, hands off. Gone, Jace. Gone, mate. You're going early, mate.
The Warrior down in back play. Justin Morgan, I do believe. So a player missing out of the line, and Campion's asking Hampstead to stop the match while the trainer rushes out. Brisbane play on. This is Darren Burns, former Rooster. Got it away. Prittis backing up. Good support play there from the number nine. The Broncos now swing it to the right. There's the try scorer, Sean Berrigan. Last tackle coming up for Brisbane. Walker got it away to Carl Webb on the last. And they're over the sideline. They ran it on the last and they pay the penalty. There was plenty of defence and it's a turnover.
Yes, and that's might be close to the fourth or fifth time they've run it on the last. But a great part of the game here for this New Zealand side. After seeming to dominate the second half, they find themselves level after looking for a knockout blow. We'll see if this New Zealand side's got some heart for the 2001 season here.
Harpy gives it on to Farfeely. He scored the first try tonight. He's dragged towards the sideline. Jones. Guttenbeal. 12-12. Less than 17 to go. It's been the Warriors in front for most of the night. In fact, all of it until the last couple of minutes when Berrigan got the try to effectively square the ledger. Jones with the kick downfield. And on the bounce picked up by Takiri. From broken play, he is dangerous, but they nail him. Jones leading the chase. Swan was up there too, and he makes that tackle as well. Brad Myers keeping the ball alive. Shane Walker, one of the interchange players. And speaking of interchange, what's happening down there, Tia?
Justin Morgan's got a problem. He's off on the bench now. They're having a look at him, assessing just how what the damage is. And Monty Beefham headed straight into the dressing room. Obviously, a lot of concern for him as well.
Thank you, Tia. And as far as interchange bench use is concerned, the Warriors have used 6, Brisbane 9. Could be a telling stat, that one, in the final 15 minutes. Takiri going to the air. Torpy doesn't have to move too far. Right down his throat. And now he brings it back. There's that stat I was talking about. 9-6. Brisbane, very busy. And Ben Eichen, among those casualties that have forced Wayne Bennett to call on his troops on the sideline. Jones got it away to Guttenbeal. Keeps it alive. Harpy. Now it comes to Henry Farfeely. He darts back infield. Links up with Jones. Provides the pass for Beverly. Miles. The Warriors not afraid to spread the ball from side to side with 15 to go. Beverly to Jones. Showing it. Cross field. Links up with Guttenbeal. And last tackle now coming up for the New Zealand Warriors. Jones, will he go into the in goal? No, he goes to the air. Some pressure back here on the Broncos. Oh, Takiri, great take under pressure. There were some Warriors coming through, but he did well.
Well, it was a good set and a good kick, wasn't it? But some good cover. It means Lottie Takiri, who's a big man, gets up high above him, takes the ball. Just keep an eye on this Brisbane side. They just don't have a kicker in general field play. As we see Takiri, not a noted kicker, putting a bomb up at the other end of the field.
Well, Takiri, it wasn't a convincing take, but he did the job. Now Brisbane starting to threaten the Warriors' line. 5 metres short of halfway. Pritis got it to Myers. Now they swing it to the left. Davia, Michael Davia trying to get away from Stacey Jones. He sticks to him like glue. Brisbane slightly in front on the tackle sheet. Up and under, some pressure on Torpy. He takes it well. Faultless game from Clinton Torpy. Farfeely now helping the big men, coming in off the flank.
Both Torpy and Farfeely have been very impressive on the high ball this season. Torpy's had a great game covering defence. He's added some spark at dummy half. And that's where they need some spark now, because this Warrior forward pack's looking a little tight as Villasanti hits it up strongly.
Warriors five out from halfway as they spread it to Harpy. Farfeely tackle almost on the halfway line. And this is the last coming up for the Warriors. They'll look for a good kick here from Jones. Little kick in behind the line. Not sure if that was the right option. Brisbane now bring it away, and they're in good field position. 40 out from their own line.
Well, it looked to be a little bit impeded, didn't he, Stacey Jones? Referee also getting a little shove in the back there. There's Lottie Takiri. Look at him go.
Takiri tackled. 10 in from touch. We watched the replay. The kick from Jones. He wasn't given a saloon passage, let me tell you. Berrigan
Spotted the gap, but it closed quickly. They worked the blind. Prittis. No one there. Saylor was looking to come in on the inside. Now he gets the pass out the back door to Darren Burns. Puts the dummy on. But the Warriors tackle him. 15 out from the line, Darren Burns. Shane Walker gives it to Myers. Across now to Carlaw. Last tackle, Brisbane, 5 metres out. Looking to hit the lead for the first time. Shane Walker to Berrigan. Last tackle, kick into the end goal. It might be too deep. It is too deep. The Warriors survived, still 12 all with 12 to go.
And once again, the Broncos falling down on that last tackle. Darren Lockyer, that's where he's been missed tonight. This time Berrigan, a little too strong. And a let off for the Warriors.
Good work by Mealy, just letting the ball go over things. Fatigue setting into this game. There's a lot of battered players out there. It's a bit of a war of attrition.
Sure is, and Jason Deff's headed into the blood bin. He's got a rather big cut under his right eye. Monty Beetham's back on the bench. He'll be okay to come back, and Justin Morgan looks like, after some running repairs, he'll be fine as well. That knee, of course, Monty Beetham had reconstructed last year.
No news on the knee of Ben Eichen here.
No news from the Brisbane Broncos dressing room. Obviously, Ben Eichen won't be back this evening.
The Warriors now with an overlap. Logan Swan throws the dummy, looking to get the pass inside. Goes to ground. Miles cleans up. Torpy takes it. And last tackle now coming up for the New Zealand Warriors. Nat Wood, a dummy half, gives it to Beverly. To Jones, the co-captain, again going to the air. Farfeely seemed to be offside. Play on, says Hampstead. And another kick from Jones, coming through his Harpy. And the Broncos are trapped again, are they? No, they're not. Takiri doing well on the far side of the field. He had a job in front of him there. Hodges now. Was denied a try in the first half. We watched the second kick from Jones.
Well, it set up well, didn't it? Lottie Takiri falling backwards. Just can't grab him. Well done. Stacey Jones has obviously pointed out Hodges after a nervous kick in the first half where he dropped it. Thinks that's where another mistake could come.
Berrigan. Taken by Harpy. Jones also helping out. Sivanasiva. Brisbane walking. Now a kick. Very disorganised there. Torpy on the kick return. Let's see what he can do. He gives it to Malley. Malley still going. Never say die attitude. Cliff Beverley from dummy half. 5 short of halfway. Less than 10 to go. Buckle up for a big finish. Even Stevens here at Ericsson. Game 2 of round 6. 12 apiece. Lowatiti taking it to the line. Over the top to nobody. Picked up by Jonathan Smith in 19. Back from a foot injury tonight, Smith. Jones to Beverly. Did well to reel in that pass. And the kick from Miles, he was taken late. Hampstead watching proceedings unfold. Play on, he says. And Takiri brings it back, got away from Beverly. Now he straightens it up. But who tackles him? Cliff Beverly. Oh, sloppy work from the Broncos there. They went to sleep. The Warriors in possession. Nat Wood now. Lowatiti from dummy half. Perhaps the Warriors are setting themselves for the field goal. Beverly's got his arm raised. It comes back to Jones. He has the shot. It looks okay. It's over. Stacey Jones, the co-captain, nails the one-pointer. The Warriors with a one-point buffer. The crowd erupts at Ericsson. New Zealand Warriors leading the Broncos 13-12.
Well, they set it up well, didn't they? I think it came on the third or the fourth tackle. And although it's right in front, they are not easy to kick. Let's have a look at Stacey. It's a lot of pressure. Oh, great work by Logan Swan there. And as a result of it, pressure coming from everywhere.
Could be a crucial one-pointer from that man. And he takes the restart on the full. The Warriors with 7 minutes and a bit more to play with their noses in front, but only just. Farfeely taken by Webke on the second. Swan.
L3, they didn't get any hands off. Come on, Broncos.
Campion. Oh, clever play, and away goes Torpy. Torpy's away. He's mowed down. Shane Walker take a bow. That was an important tackle, and he forces the mistake as well.
Well, a great ball from Beverly then. A difficult pass from Campion. Beverly was good enough to catch and pass in one motion, and Torpy flying down the sideline. Swan hit it up.
Well, the thing here is you watch the line of Clinton Torpy. He hits the ball straight. This ball had to be down, nothing doing, bang. Through he goes. Just a little bit of a mistake at the end, unfortunate.
Let it out, let it out.
A great ball it was. And Torpy, he is an excitement machine. But the mistake there, forced. And now the Broncos in possession. They swing it to the left. The pass on the inside to Shane Walker. Or Chris Walker, I should say. Inside ball. Darren Burns working the blind. Got it away to Shane Walker in 16.
That tackle had to be made.
It's still on for the Broncos. They trail by one. It comes across to Webke. He's lost the ball. Well, the hard head of this Brisbane pack comes up with a mistake at a vital time.
Well, as you see the Auckland Warriors work it out, there's a tackle there on the New Zealand right-hand side. Francis Mealy came off his wing. Try saver, possibly the game.
Jonathan Smith, 30 out from his own line. Brisbane have exhausted all their bench players. All 12 interchange movements have been utilised. The crowd calling for offside as the Warriors swing it to the left. The kick downfield turns Siler around. He has been contained tonight, and it goes over the sideline.
Very close to a 40-20 there too. I think he might have been just out by a metre or so, Beverly.
Well, I think with 5 minutes left in this game of football, the biggest thing about that kick was the fact that it found touch. Just eats up an extra 30 seconds of time. New Zealand Warriors haven't been able to get across the Broncos try line in the second half, and the 1 point while they were down there might just do the trick.
Let's keep ourselves straight, Broncos.
Wasn't far off a 40-20. As Darryl rightly points out, this will eat up the clock like Pac-Man. Brisbane now with their acting captain, Wendell Saylor. And the ball control favouring Brisbane by not a lot.
Hands off, hands off.
The first handling mistake from memory was very much deep into the first half. Oh, they forced the mistake again. Burns dives on the scraps. Hampstead says knock on against Brisbane with just over four to play.
Yes, of course, in the last 4 minutes and you're down, you've got to actually try and push a pass, don't you? Two men on him, trying to get it out there. And by the way, Costo Pac-Man went out about 20 years ago, mate. She's Digimons and Pokemons now.
I'm not up with it, Darryl. But the Warriors are certainly up with it tonight. The chant goes up here at Ericsson. Miles. The home side seemingly headed for victory tonight. Smith plays it back. Nat Wood from dummy half. He's an experienced customer. 20 out. The Warriors come to Francis Mealy at first receiver. What's he doing in there? He's looking to score a try. That's what he's doing. Beverly now. Cut out pass to Torby on the wing. Dancing with the defence. And Saylor shows him the sideline. Less than three to go. Beverly to Jones. Juggles it. Did well. Back to Guttenbeal. Trying to bust him up the middle. Got it away. Villasanti couldn't collect the pass, and here comes the counter-attack from the Broncos. Berrigan looking to milk the penalty, and David Miles was all over him like a rash.
Set up for a finish here, aren't we? You see it happen.
Fasten those seatbelts. David Miles here, the villain. And Brisbane now into enemy territory with that touch finder. Just over 2 minutes to go.
And the Broncos looking at stealing the draw. Darryl, who kicks the goal?
I don't think you'll see them go for the field goal, Tony. They'll either want to win it, they won't want to draw it here.
Prittis from dummy half. Gives it away. And good second phase play here from Brisbane in the face of adversity. They swing it to the right. And that's tackle number three with just over 90 seconds to go. Shane Walker getting to his feet. Webke offloading back to Takiri. Brisbane keeping the ball alive. Desperation stakes here for them. Chris Walker trying to stand up. His opposite pass in field is snuffed out. Jonathan Smith in 19 comes away with it. That could well be the ball game.
Had to try something, didn't they? As there's open space here.
Well, the heartbeat would have been pumping there for Daniel Anderson.
Last week, Walker, he stood Robbie O'Davis up and took on the sideline and come up a winner. Today, not quite there.
Some of these Broncos are offside. Big shoulder charge coming in. And we have less than a minute to go. Webke and the likes looking to force the mistake.
They should get one more chance with the ball, Brisbane.
Campion. He'll savour this victory tonight if they can hang on. So too that man, Jason Deeth, and a battle-scarred Deeth at that. The kick for touch is a smart one with 30 seconds to go. And this will be the quickest scrum formation in the history of the Broncos if the Broncs have their way.
The New Zealand Warriors have never beaten the Broncos since they've been in the competition. Winfield Cup, Super League, and now the NRL.
Brisbane now spreading the ball from the scrum. Hodges, and that is full time, surely.
Two to go.
Waiting for the hooter, they'll get one more play. This could be controversial, but he's chopped down, and it's all over. The Warriors in a real shock. They have upset the Broncos. Unbelievable. Amazing scenes here at Ericsson. The Warriors, led by Kevin Campion, a former Bronco, downing the Glamour Boys 13-12. Finally, the duck against the Bronx is broken. It's taken them 10 times, but finally they've cracked it. Stacey Jones, he will sleep well tonight. We said 2 weeks ago when the Warriors beat the Dragons, Auckland would be rocking. Well, you can times that by 10 tonight.
Well, they've done very, very well, haven't they? And this crowd is entitled to be as ecstatic as they are. The second half, there's the score. There's not much in it. These scenes will stay with a few people. But it's only round six, and the Warriors off to a terrific start.
Well, they dominated the game for so long, the Warriors. They deserve this win. There's a parent there where the Broncos withstood all that pressure, scored a try, and in previous seasons, you probably would have thought the Warriors, that would have been it for the Warriors. But this is a stronger team. They're fortified in defence. They got plenty of skill at the backs. And even in the last few minutes, they were throwing the ball around. Good luck to them.
You'd think they'd won the grand final. Amazing scenes. Let's go sideline. Tiara Party is with Wendell Saylor.
Obviously a fantastic night for the Auckland side, not so good for you.
Yeah, Teal, we're used to coming over here and winning, you know. And winning this year is going to be a bit harder. Obviously, Gordy and Darren Lockyer are out, but no excuse, with some good young kids there. We aimed up, I thought, but like the Warriors are playing great this year. I've been watching them all year, they've been a bit unlucky, but tonight at our expense, though, you know, they beat us. The crowds are back, and it's good for New Zealand Rugby League, I think.
They really came to you with their forward pack that, you know, traditionally not as physical as they were tonight?
Oh, yeah, certainly. I mean, they've always been a physical side, but they never go for 80 minutes. So I think tonight they showed, I suppose, with Kevin Campion, Villasani coming on. You know, they played great tonight, and they had 2 points that we lost, but, I mean, they earned them tonight, and congratulations to them.
The crowd here absolutely love you, Wendell. You weren't able to get as much ball as you possibly would have liked.
No, the Warriors were good in defence all night. Didn't have much room to run, but, yeah, they played really well. Their attack's great. Stacey Jones played awesome. And showing the great player he is, 12 all, he kicks a field goal. That's a class player, and tonight we just didn't have class players to overcome the Warriors tonight.
Cheers, Wendell.
Thanks, mate, Warner.
There he is, Wendell Saylor, obviously disappointed with that scoreline. Full time, a real upset, the Warriors 13-12.
History has been made at Ericsson Stadium in a week 6 of the Premiership. For the first time in their very short history, the Warriors have beaten the Brisbane Broncos, but only just. A Stacey Jones field goal. He's sidelined with Te Aro Pāti.
Stacey, fantastic to come away with a win.
Very good, yeah. Our first win against the Broncos, and we're really wrapped. You know, even though they were... had a few players out, but you know, we stuck to our game plan. I thought our forwards sort of laid a really good platform in defence, and good win.
The loss of Gordon Tallis and their key players must have given you a lot of confidence.
I guess so, but you know, you don't sort of look back on those things. I mean, you can probably get too much confidence sometimes when you see players like that out, and we treated them with the utmost respect, and. You know, those guys, Tallis and Lockie, had to play, you know. I mean, I'm sure the boys would have played the same again tonight.
I know one of the areas that you have been working on is being more concerned about what yous are doing with the football than what the other side is doing. And it certainly shows out there tonight.
Yeah, I mean, the boys just supported each other really well. You know, you can't say more about our forwards. You know, guys like Richard Villasani, you know, he just played, went hard all night. You know, Campo led the boys around. Really well, and the rest of the forwards, Arwin, Logues, Monty, Doc, you know, I've forgotten someone, Justin Morgan, you know, those guys, Ali, awesome.
You lose a few players just before kickoff, and everything just rolls on like normal. A great squad.
Yeah, we lost Ivan, you know, yesterday. He came down with food poisoning, I think, and you know, Tupi, Clint stepped up tonight. He was safe at the back, and he made some good runs.
On a personal note, the drop goal that you kicked, appropriate that Stacey Jones should win the game against the Brisbane Broncos after 6 years.
Yeah, it's been a long time, and geez, we've had some close games against them, we've had some hidings, and 1 point is good enough for me.
There's nothing better than playing Brisbane. They're always a real challenge, and you walk away very, very satisfied.
Oh, they're the benchmark of the whole comp, Brisbane. Every team wants to be like them. They're going for a bit of a rebuilding stage right now, and you know, like, so are we. So, I mean, you know, we'll improve week by week, and you know, if we can get some good support like we did tonight, but people come back, you know, I'm sure we'll put on performances like this tonight for them.
Final word on your half partner, Fluffy Beverly. He's outstanding tonight.
Oh, I thought it was his best game he's played for the Warriors. Outstanding. He talked all night. He led the boys around as well. He got it stuck in there. So he's going well. Good on. Cheers, Tia.
Stacey Jones, and I think Te Aro Pāti's question was on the mark. Quite fitting that this man, who has been considered the franchise player for the New Zealand Warriors, gets the one to create a little bit of history. Only his fifth ever field goal in first grade, and what a field goal it was.
Oh, it was. It's an absolutely wonderful night, I think, for New Zealand Rugby League, and in particular for guys like Stacey being involved right from the inception. But yeah, all around the park, you had the youngsters again to the fore, yeah? But also, I think it would be remiss if we didn't mention Campion's contribution.
Huge.
Yeah, we saw instances where the guy was showing no respect to the Broncos, and I think it's that attitude which has been perhaps been missing, where we're shown too much respect to sides like that. But at the same time, I also recognise in Brisbane, this football side, they were on the back of very, very little ball, and they didn't know they were beaten.
Yes, no, and I think that was the key, and Wendell Saylor showed true respect to both sides, as Stacey Jones showed huge respect to the Brisbane Broncos. They may have been down on talent and power, but the Brisbane Broncos only lost by 1 point. Remember that. They are still very much a class act. Here are the numbers from the game, and Pete, just look through the numbers, the time and possession, pretty level, and the time in the opposition half pretty much starts to talk about the last part of the game for the New Zealand Warriors.
But quality as well, you know, when you look at your completion rate, relatively high for both sides. You know, they've But it's all about their time and possession. A lot of that, I think, is about the penalties, about their kicking game of also the Auckland, New Zealand Warriors as well, yeah?
So the Warriors win this one 13-12 and the fans go home happy. There'll be lots of stories spoken about this one as they think about history being created at Ericsson Stadium. And Peter has already mentioned the man that showed no respect to his former club, Kevin Campion.
Kevin, obviously very delighted.
Yeah, mate, it was a great win. I mean, we come out here and expecting to win. We've been, you know, picking up form each week. And, you know, we just topped off from our last week against Parramatta with a good win.
It's obviously important that you roll on and enjoy tonight, and next week's another week.
Yeah, that's right, mate. It's a long season. It's, you know, you're just going to take a week at a time. Every game's a hard game. And we'll go back on Monday, get straight back in the training, and we've got to back up against Newcastle next Saturday.
Right across the park, there were some outstanding performances.
Yeah, it was great, mate. I mean, I've got to commend our forward pack. You know, we sort of didn't muscle up that well last week, and, you know, we come out firing tonight, and I think the boys did a great job.
Richard Villasani and the back three in particular, outstanding.
Oh, mate, yeah, so we've got some big boys who can sting a lot of players, you know. We've just got to, you know, get consistency, you know, get a couple of wins under our belt. We just can't go through the season one win, one loss, you know. We've just got to back it up next week.
Good on, mate.
Thanks, Dave.